So I just came from a doctor's appointment and I am on the way to Raph's house because we're gonna hang out today. And he just texted me with some great news. So I'm really excited to see him. And that is that he got hired at a job that he's been trying to find for the longest time. And yeah, so they called him at work, I guess, yesterday, and he couldn't pick up, and like by the time he got off it was already too late. So he called this morning, and then while I was at my appointment, he texted me and said that he got hired. So yeah, I'm like on the way right now to his house and I'm gonna see him and we're gonna hang out. Today was supposed to be just a celebration for my birthday, but now it's gonna be also a celebration for Raph getting a new job. So I'm really excited, really happy for him. And yeah, let's go see him. Congratulations!
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Hi, you got the job. So tell us a story.
So I got a call yesterday from an HR rep from Sutter, which is the company that I'm trying to work for. And so I gave him, he called me yesterday and I couldn't pick up because I was at work. And then so today I gave him a call and he pretty much told me that, you know, we want to extend the offer, the job offer that we gave you on the interview. I was like, okay, that sounds good. And then he was like, so it's going to be 80 hours per week, or 80 hours every 2 weeks, full time with full benefits. And then he told me the salary also. So I was like, oh man, dude, that sounds really good. Because initially the offer that they gave me, or they told me, was going to be, I think it was a per diem or part time. So it's not going to be as, you know, I'm not going to have that much hours or probably even benefits. So then he said, you know, we want to extend the offer to this and this for this much salary. So everything sounded good, so I was like, oh man, heck yeah, yeah, give me that. And then so he pretty much told me the logistics of the whole thing, like how, you know, you're gonna start on the 16th of November, but before that, you know, we're gonna do a background check, physical, health check, and all that kind of stuff, pretty much all the logistics before you're able to start. So I guess right now I'm just gonna wait for more emails so I can get myself started with background checks and all that stuff. And yeah, and if everything goes well, I start on the 16th of November.
So we're here at the restaurant we made reservations for. It's in San Carlos, it's called Creola. And we're like literally the only ones in this restaurant. There's like nobody here. We thought they were closed because there's like nobody in here. But yeah, we are looking at the menu right now, and I think we're gonna do this jazzy lunch special, which is appetizer, salad, and entree for $18.
Well, this is mine. This is the ahi tuna
tartar.
I called it tare tare, just kidding. So it has pretty much seafood stuff and it looks hella good. I'm about to try this out.
This is pretty good. It kind of reminds me of poke, but with like a crunch. And it's not salty. It looks salty, but it's not salty. It's perfect. And the little stuff on it, like the onion leaves and all that, makes everything taste pretty good.
Are you going to eat that cucumber?
No. I don't like cucumber, so I'm not going to eat that. It tastes like cornbread.
Yeah, with crab.
Yeah, there you go, I just use the crab. You see the sauce. That sounds good. It's like a... I don't know, it's hard to explain, but it has that familiar taste, so it's good.
Oh no, it's falling
apart. Can I use the other hand? Yeah.
Okay.
Doesn't it remind you of poke?
Oh, it is rockfish.
Yeah.
There's so much flavor. It's good.
Is it salty?
Mm-hmm. No, it's not, actually.
Yeah, oh god, I hate that. I don't like cucumber, guys.
How?
I don't know. Good. I'm about to eat the rest of that. I just elevated. So I got the shrimp and crawfish etouffee. It's pretty much got crawfish, shrimp, and rice. And this is pretty much how I like my food. Everything's together, the rice, the soup, and everything else. And I'm about to try this out. Shrimp and crawfish.
It's pretty good.
It's got that seafood taste, and you taste all the herbs and stuff, and then you put it in rice. I like rice, and you smash it all up together, and it's pretty good. It's really good, actually. Try it.
I should have grabbed the rice for today. You should mix that together.
I know, I should.
It's gonna be so good. So I got the shrimp and grits. And I've never had grits before, so it's my first time. And I've always been wanting to try it. So I'm pretty sure this place is a little more reliable because it's Creole. So I'm gonna try it. Cut my shrimp. It's a bit. There's sausage, andouille sausage here.
That looks like mashed potatoes. Is that mashed potatoes?
It's grits.
Oh, yeah, what the heck? One try. It tastes like cheese.
I think they put cheese in here.
It's good. I like it.
Yeah, let's eat.
It feels like you need a bigger portion. Because for me, that I'm gonna finish that quick.
Eat slow. Okay, let's eat.
Thank you.
this is our dessert. It's beignets with bananas, caramelized bananas, and burnt caramel sauce with whipped cream. And this is our first time. Raph's been craving beignets forever.
And I don't even know how it tastes like.
No, craving it. But he's just, I mean, not craving it, I guess wanting to try it really bad. So you can try it first. I'll give you the honors.
I think I gotta try it. Okay. Right now, I'm tasting the caramel. And you know, when it's burnt sugar, it gets really chewy. So I'm not really tasting the beignet. I'm trying it. It's like a mixture of croissant and donut.
And then mix it up with the whipped cream and banana. It's really good. And the caramel taste.
So it's my first time too, so I'm gonna try it. I'll just get this one. All I know about this is that it's like a donut. Similar to a donut. Oh god, this is hard to. Should I try it by itself?
Yeah, try it by itself.
It's just like a fried donut.
Yeah. And then you add the
try the burnt caramel and banana now. Everything just goes together so well. Yummy.